Everyone, welcome back to new video. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can perform type safe navigation in your multi-modeler project. So multi-modeler project is a very common approach if you want to make your project more scalable, more reusable, more testable. Then we will use multi-modeler. And if you want to perform navigation in multi-modeler project by connecting your module each other, then ultimately in the future you are gonna end up with circular dependency. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can avoid circular dependency problem and perform navigation with the help of type safe navigation, which is introduces by Android recently. So let's get started. So first thing first, go to the description box where you can find my GitHub repository link. Download the project and open up into your Android Studio. So this project looks something like this. So we have common module, we have a feature directory that contains two different module in it. We have authentication and the dashboard feature. So for this project, we are having only two screens. The first screen is for our authentication and the second screen is for our dashboard. If we are looking into its Gradle file, so open up your dashboard build Gradle file. So here we are having dependency for Dagger Hilt, for our navigation and for our serialization. On the top, we are having few plugins. So this plugin is actually used for our serialization. This is used for our Dagger Hilt. And this is used to enable parcelized annotation for our project. And this KAPT is actually used to use KAPT here in our build Gradle file. Basically, it's a Kotlin annotation processor. All right, so this is our basic setup for this build Gradle file. So similarly, we are having for authentication. And in the common, we are having only two dependency. The first one is for our navigation and the second one is for our serialization. On the top, we are having serialization and parcelized plugin. In the module app level, we are having same dependency for Dagger, for navigation and for serialization. On the top, we are having its plugin respectively. So here you can see serialization plugin, parcelized plugin, Dagger Hilt and KAPT. All right, so this is a very basic setup of my project. So first thing first, in the common module, I'm gonna create few things because this common module is accessible to all of our modules. So if you want to create anything that is accessible to all of our modules, then you can create that thing in this particular module. So first I'm gonna create a feature naming interface, and this interface contains one function naming a register graph, okay? So here we are having our nav host controller and nav graph builder. All right, so one more thing, we require destinations for our screen. So for that, I'm gonna create one more file naming navigation utils. This is a file, and this file contains a serial class. The first serial class name would be subgraph destinations, because in multi-modular architecture, we are gonna create small navigation subgraph for each module, and due to that reason, first we are gonna create its destinations. So this is our subgraph destination, and I'm gonna create data object naming auth, and I'm gonna extend this thing with subgraph destination. Similarly, we are having second subgraph destination, which is a dashboard, and I'm gonna use here subgraph destination. So in order to use these two data objects as a destination, you can use here serializable annotation. All right, so this is for our subgraph destinations. Now within the subgraphs, we have screens, and in order to create destinations for our screen, I'm gonna use a serial class naming dist, and within this dist, I'm gonna create this destinations. So first we are having data object for authentication, extend this thing with destinations. Second, we are having dashboard and extend this thing with destination. And here I'm gonna use serializable annotation so that I can use these two data objects as a destinations. So this is our subgraph destination, and every subgraph contains few screens in it. And due to that reason, here we are having destinations for that screens. So this is for our common module. Now let's begin with our feature authentication. So within this, I'm gonna create few packages first. So within this, I'm having first package for our dependency injection. Then we are having one more package for our navigation. So let's begin with our navigation, and here I'm going to create a file, and let's call this auth feature navigation, and I'm going to create an interface naming auth feature and extend this thing with feature interface that is present in our common module. And just below to it, I'm going to create a class naming auth feature implementation and implement my auth feature interface. So this interface contains only one function, register graph. So this function register graph is eventually used to register the sub navigation graph to our main graph. So our main graph eventually present in our app module, and in order to attach this small subgraph to our app module main graph, we're gonna use dependency injection. So we'll do that later, but first thing first, let's create our navigation subgraph. So for that, here we are having navigation graph builder, so simply use it, and this will contain a navigation. So let's provide this subgraph destination. So now to provide subgraph destination to our nested navigation subgraph, I'm gonna use here subgraph destination dot auth. Okay, now it become a small navigation graph. That means this will contain few screens in it. So for that, we're gonna pass start destination. I mean, which screen you want to open first. So for me, I'm gonna create my screen first. So for that, we are having composable, and this composable has destinations. So for that, I'm gonna use my destination dot auth. And within this pair of parentheses, I'm gonna pass my screen. So I haven't created my screen yet. So before creating our screen, let's pass the start destination. So it's same destination dot auth. So here you can see this will eventually generate my small nested navigation subgraph, and this subgraph contain few screens in it. So this is our screen, and this start destination will eventually tell us the starting point of our nested navigation subgraph. So now it's time to create the screen. So in order to create a screen, I'm going to create a package naming screens, and within this screen I'm having a file auth screen, composable auth screen, and within this we are having box modifier fill max size, its content alignment on the center, and within this we are having text. So this text says auth feature, and here I'm having modifier clickable and use on click dot invoke to transfer its clickable event to our parent composable. Alright, so now it's time to use this authentication screen. Go to your auth feature navigation and use it over here. Similarly, for our dashboard module, I'm gonna create few packages and do the same thing. So here in the dashboard, I'm gonna create my package for dependency injection. Similarly for our navigation, and lastly for our screens. Okay, so in our navigation, I'm gonna create a file. That file name would be dashboard feature. This is an interface, and this interface use our feature interface, which is present in our common module. Now, just below to it, I'm gonna use a dashboard feature implementation and use my dashboard feature. And within this, I'm having one function, register graph. So let's implement this. Within this, we are having nav graph builder, navigation, and use your subgraph destination, which is coming from our subgraph destination sealed class that contain dashboard in it. And in place of start destination, I'm gonna use my destination dot dashboard. And within it, we are having composable, and this composable requires its destination. So for that, I'm gonna use destination dot dashboard. Now it's time to create dashboard screen. So for that, I'm gonna create a file naming dashboard screen. Here we are having composable naming dashboard screen. And within this, we are having box modifier fill max size, content alignment on the center, and within this we are having text which says dashboard feature. And when your user click onto this particular thing, I'm gonna transfer the clickable event to our parent composable. So for that, I'm gonna pass a function within this naming on click and use it over here. Now I'm gonna use dashboard screen in my dashboard feature. So this is our implementation. So this is our dashboard feature implementation, and this is our authentication feature implementation. Now I'm gonna provide this authentication feature implementation with the help of Dagger Hilt. For that, let's create a object, and object name would be auth module. Use install in, and within this I'm having singleton component class. Use module over here, and within this authentication module, I'm gonna provide function provide authentication feature, return the authentication feature implementation. Okay, similarly for our dashboard, I'm gonna create a module and call this a dashboard module. On the top we are having install in singleton component class, return type would be dashboard feature, and here I'm gonna use a return keyword with dashboard feature implementation. All right so this will eventually provide me dashboard feature, and this authentication module provide authentication feature provides me authentication feature implementation, authentication feature navigation. And here I'm gonna use my navhost controller and want to navigate from authentication screen to our dashboard screen, the destination dot dashboard. So this dashboard destination is eventually representing the screen which is present to our dashboard subgraph. Alright, so now we are pretty much done with our feature modules. Now it's time to go in our app module. So first thing first, I'm gonna set up my Dagger Hill. So for that, I'm gonna create a class naming base application. Extend this class with application use hilt android app. Now register this app in our manifest. Okay, so by doing this, our Dagger Hill is set up for this project. Now I'm going to create a package for our dependency injection. So this is our dependency injection package, and I'm going to create a data class. So this data class name would be default navigator. This will contain two things. The first one is our authentication feature, and the second one is our dashboard feature. Now I'm going to create module. So for that, we are having an object, and I'm going to call this app module. This is a module, so I'm going to use here module annotation, and within this I'm going to provide function provide default navigator. Okay, and the requirement of default navigator would be our authentication feature and the dashboard feature. Return type would be default navigator. Return default navigator, pass your authentication feature and the dashboard feature. Okay, now go to your main activity. And within this main activity, I'm going to create a composable, which is a main navigation. And within this, I'm going to create navhost. Okay, so requirement of navhost would be nav controller. So let's create our nav controller. With the help of a remember nav controller, I'm going to create my nav controller and pass it over here. And in place of graph, I'm going to remove this graph with start destination, and in the starting I'm gonna use my subgraph destination and open up my authentication nested navigation subgraph. Okay, and within this I'm gonna register the small subgraph which is present into our modules. So for that we require this default navigator, and this default navigator is created or initialized with the help of our app module. So for that I'm gonna use here inject let init variable default navigator and simply pass this default navigator in our main navigation and use it over here. So default navigator contain authentication feature, and simply I'm gonna register that graph, I mean the small navigation subgraph, into our main graph. So our main graph is eventually created with the help of navhost, and this is a subgraph, so I'm gonna attach this small navigation subgraph to our main graph. So for that we require two things. The first one is our nav controller, and the second one is our navigation graph builder, so which is this. Similarly, I'm gonna register my dashboard feature. So yeah, we are pretty much done. Now I'm gonna use main navigation here. So main navigation, pass your default navigator. So let's execute this application. Alright, so our app executed successfully. This is our authentication screen. So when I click to this authentication feature text, we will navigate to our dashboard feature. So yeah, our navigation worked fine. So by using this approach, you can perform the navigation, or you can say type safe navigation, in your multi-modular project. So let's recapitulate what we did. So first, we write this interface that is used to register our small subgraph to our main graph, and this is our navigation utils which contain all of our destinations for subgraph and for our screens. After that, in the authentication, we create this thing, this authentication feature interface, and implement this authentication feature interface with the help of authentication feature implementation class. And here what we did, we actually create a small subgraph with the help of navigation function, and this subgraph has its own destination which is coming from our subgraph destination.authentication. Because this is a small navigation subgraph, that means this will contain few other screens within this. And due to that reason, here we need to pass the start destination, which is destination.authentication. And this is our actual composable corresponding to this destination. And lastly, in the app module, we have created this default navigator, and with the help of Dagger Hilt, I'm gonna pass the implementation of authentication feature and dashboard feature, and use this default navigator in our main navigation composable. So this main navigation composable contain our main graph. So our main graph is created with the help of navigation host. Navigation host requirement is nav controller and the start destination. So make sure this start destination is the start destination of your subgraph route, not your screen destination, which is present into your subgraph. So due to that reason, I have passed my subgraph destination authentication, and this eventually open up my authentication feature. And just below to it, we are actually adding this small navigation subgraph to our main graph with the help of register graph. So this is for our authentication feature, and this is for our dashboard feature. So yeah, this is a very simple flow of our TypeSafe navigation in multimodal project.